Welcome back to my channel Smart Learning, where learning is made simple. In today's video, we are going to discuss about the smart tricks to learn the table 6. Now let's first see how table 6 needs to be read. 1 6 are 6, 2 6 are 12, 3 6 are 18, 4 6 are 24, 5 6 are 30, 6 6 are 36, 7 6 are 42, 8 6 are 48, 9 6 are 54, and 10 6 are 60. It is important for the child to read the table properly. So once you are able to read the table properly, then you can make them understand what each of the row mean, because they need to know the purpose of learning the tables. For example, if you take the row 7 of table 6, it is nothing but 7 groups with 6 items in each group. So we need to find the total number of items in these groups, for which we perform multiplication 7 into 6 to obtain the result 42. So this is the purpose of learning various tables. So once you explain all these concepts to the kids, only then move to the next step of introducing various tricks for them to memorize the tables and also the different patterns that we obtain in these results of table 6. There is a trick to write the table 6 sequentially. You need to first put 2 capital W and then skip count by 2 in the direction as shown here. So you need to skip count by 2 starting from here. So 2, 4, 6, 8, and when it comes to 10, you need to just put a 0. So once you skip count by 2 and number the W, then you need to prefix the numbers. You start from this middle one and prefix it with 0 and 1 in this row and 2 here, and when you see a 0, you need to increase this 2 by 1 to write 3, and follow the same for the next W, where you start from the middle with this same number and then you increase this by 1 and number here, and then increase it by 1 and number here, and when you see a 0, you again increase this 5 by 1 to write 6. So now when you observe here, you obtain the results of tables 6, 6, 12, 18, 24, 30, 36, 42, 48, 54, and 60. So the only two concepts that you need to remember is the skip count by 2, and you need to prefix the numbers in the correct order. But this is not going to help your kid to memorize the table. Instead, they can write the table only sequentially. But our main aim is to make the kids memorize the table, for which I will explain each row of table 6 and the trick that can be used to memorize each row. So before moving into the memorizing part, we will first observe few patterns that we obtain in the results of table 6, and then we can move into the next part, which is to memorize the table. By now, the children should be familiar with the concept of even and odd. So the numbers that ends with 0, 2, 4, 6 and 8 are the even numbers, and the numbers that ends with 1, 3, 5, 7, 9 are the odd numbers. The reason for me giving a recap of these even and odd numbers is that this is going to be used for obtaining the result of table 6. When 6 is multiplied by an even number from 2 to 8, the 1's digit of the result ends with the same number with which 6 is being multiplied, and half of the result becomes the 10th digit of the final result. For example, let's take 8 being multiplied by 6. So since 6 is being multiplied by an even number 8, the result of 8 into 6 ends with the same 8, and half of this 8 becomes the 10th digit of the result. So when you club these both, you get the answer of 8 into 6, which is nothing but 48. When 6 is multiplied by an odd number from 1 to 9, the 1's digit of the final result is 5 more or less than the number with which 6 is being multiplied. Which means, for example, let's take 3 into 6. The result of 3 into 6 is nothing but 18. So when you observe here, the 1's digit 8 is 5 more than this 3. And when you observe this, where 9 is being multiplied by 6, the 1's digit of the result is 5 less than 9. And the pattern obtained for every 3 rows of table 6 is 6, 3, 9. So these are the results of each row of table 6. So when you observe the pattern, the result of the first row is 6. And when you observe the next one, it is 12. So when you add these two digits, you get 3. And when you add these two digits, 1 and 8, you get 9. So we obtain the pattern 6, 3, 9. Again, when you observe the results of the next 3 rows, 2 plus 4 is 6, 3 plus 0 is 3, 3 plus 6 is 9. So again you get the pattern 6, 3, 9. So this pattern repeats throughout the table 6. And when you need to multiply a number by 6, you can just multiply the number by 5 and add the result to the number with which 6 is being multiplied to obtain the final result. For example, when 7 needs to be multiplied by 6, you can first multiply 7 by 5, which is 35, and add 7 to this 35 to get 42. So these are the various tricks that can be adapted to learn the table 6 very easily. Now let's discuss how to make the child memorize the table 6 by seeing each of the row individually. When you look at the first row, 1 needs to be multiplied by 6, and since we know that the result of 1 into 6 is the same as 6 into 1, you can use the trick that we use for the learning of table 1. Any number multiplied by 1 gives the result as the same number with which 1 is being multiplied. Therefore, 1 sixes are the same 6. Let's move to the next row where 2 needs to be multiplied by 6. Since we know that 2 into 6 is the same as 6 into 2, you can use the trick that we use for obtaining the result of table 2, where you can skip count by 2 6 times to obtain the result 12, or you can use the other trick that I have explained while teaching table 2. Since we split the table 2 into 2 parts, 2 into 6 becomes the first row of the second part of table 2, so you need to just prefix 2 by 1, which becomes 12, so you can obtain the result 12. Or this is a new trick that I have explained just few minutes back, where when 6 is being multiplied by an even number, the result will end with the same 2, and half of this number becomes the 10th digit of the final result. Therefore, 6 2s are, or 2 6s are, is nothing but 12. Now let's move to the next row where 3 needs to be multiplied by 6. I have already provided this rhyming sentence while we learnt the table 3. 11, 12, 13, 6 3s are 18. When we make the kids to repeat this sentence 3 to 4 times, they will never forget the result of 3 into 6, which is 18. Now let's move to the next row where 4 needs to be multiplied by 6. Now since 4 is an even number, and since it is being multiplied by 6, the result will end with the same 4, and half of the 4 becomes the 10th digit of the result. Therefore, result of 4 into 6 is nothing but 24. Or you can use the other trick. Since there is only one number in between 4 and 6, which is 5, you can first multiply 5 by 5 to get 25 and subtract 1 from the result, which is 25, to obtain 24, which becomes the result of 4 into 6. When you look at the fifth row where 5 is being multiplied by 6, since we've already learned the table 5, you can either skip count by 5 6 times to obtain the result 30, or can use the other trick where when 5 is being multiplied by an even number, the result obtained ends with 0, and half of 6, which is 3, becomes the 10th digit of the result. So these are the first 5 rows of table 6, which has already been learnt by you unknowingly when you learnt the tables 1 to 5. So I have explained each of the row again in detail for the kid to have a clear understanding of the whole table of table 6. Now let's move to the 6th row of table 6. Since 6 again is an even number and is being multiplied by 6, the result of 6 into 6 ends with 6, and half of 6 is nothing but 3, which becomes the 10th digit of the result. Therefore 6 6s are 36. Let's move to the next row where 7 is being multiplied by 6. In this case, you can use either of the two tricks which I'm going to explain now. First, you can either multiply 7 by 5 to get 35 and add one more 7 to this result 35 to obtain the final result 42, or you can use the finger trick that I have explained in my previous videos, which is one of the important trick to be taught to the kids for the learning of tables 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. So for using this finger trick, you need to put up all your fingers and start numbering from the little finger from 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. So when you reach the thumb of both the hands, the number that your thumb gets is 10. Now since we need to multiply 7 by 6, you need to just rotate your hand and touch the fingers that has been numbered 7 and 6 on your left and right hand respectively, and count the number of fingers that are between these fingers, including the fingers that has been touched, to obtain the result 3 here, which needs to be written here, and find the number of fingers that are on either side of the fingers that has been touched and multiply those numbers to obtain the result 12. Now since 12 is a 2 digit number, you need to add this 10th digit to the number 3 to obtain 42. So when you look at this 8th row where 8 needs to be multiplied by 6, and since 8 again is an even number, the result of 6 into 8 ends with the same 8, and half of 8 is nothing but 4, which becomes the 10th digit of the final result. Therefore 8 6s are 48. If you look at the 9th row of table 6, where 9 needs to be multiplied by 6, and since we know that the result of 9 to 6 is the same as 6 into 9, and having learned the table 9 already, you can use either of the tricks that we use for remembering table 9 to obtain the result of this row. So, since 9 is being multiplied by 6, you need to reduce 6 by 1 to get the 10th digit of the result, and you need to find the number that when added to is 5 equals 9, which can be found by taking away 5 from 9, which is 4. Or you can use the simple trick, which is by using our fingers, where you need to put up all the 10 fingers and bend the 6th finger and count the number of finger towards the left and right of the finger you have put down, and club both answers together to obtain the final result. So when you bend the 6th finger, you get 5 fingers to your left and 4 fingers to your right to obtain the result 54, which becomes the result of 9 into 6 or 6 into 9. And finally, for the 10th row, where 10 is being multiplied by 6, and since we know that the result of 10 into 6 is the same as 6 into 10, and having learned table 10 already, you can just obtain the result of this row by using this trick, where any number multiplied by 10 gives the same number followed by a 0 as a result. So since here 10 is being multiplied by 6, 6 needs to be followed by a 0 to obtain final result 60. So I hope this video would have been helpful for the kids to memorize the table 6, since I've explained each of the row in detail and the trick to be followed for remembering each of the row. Now let's see the learning outcome. By the end of this video, kids should be able to recite table 6. They should be able to write the table 6 sequentially by using the W trick. And they should also be able to answer instantly when any number from 1 to 9 is multiplied by 6 by using the tricks and tips explained in the video. If you have found something useful in this video, please like, share and subscribe to my channel Smart Learning, and also click the bell icon to get notifications about my upcoming videos.